So the switch to GT came about mainly through an open opportunity for us. You know, it was amazing to have a company approach us who was just as excited about the racing as we were. Well, they had in the past had a solid race team, and that's what they wanted to continue and build on. And, you know, that was the same thing we wanted to do, and that opportunity was too good to pass up. A fresh start is a good thing for us, and, you know, going into a race season with a company like GT behind us is, you know, an incredible boost for me. One Industries approached us at the end of last year, and they had a whole new range of race gear coming out targeted towards mountain biking, and they've got huge experience racing in the moto world, and, you know, they're going to bring that to mountain biking and be able to help us with that, and, you know, we were stoked to be able to get on board with those guys. The first thing I noticed on testing the Fury was the weight. You know, it's much lighter than what I'm used to, much lighter than what I've raced on in the past. You know, that's only a positive thing for racing World Cups. You know, that is a huge advantage for me. Suspension, it's very linear. It's a lot less progressive than what I've ridden in the past. You know, it doesn't ramp up as much. It really allows me to use all the suspension. The suspension is very impressive. Obviously, the independent drivetrain is going to help with the pedaling, and that's going to help the bike sprint out of turns, hit those long straights on a racetrack much better, and, you know, you really notice that. The geometry on the bike is slightly different to what I'm used to, and working with Fox and working with the other sponsors, you know, to make alterations to the components, you know, we've managed to get the bike completely down to the setup, how I run it, you know, how I run it on a fast, steep World Cup racetrack with the right bottom bracket height, with the right head angle, and, you know, I'm stoked to be able to say I'm running a bike with my perfect geometry now. The difference between the carbon Fury and the aluminium frames I've ridden in the past are very subtle. You know, they're not huge differences, but the small things, like you don't get quite so much feedback on the small chattery bumps. You know, the bike seems to take that out, but at the same time it almost feels, you know, like there's less flex there. It's quite a strange feeling, but definitely a positive one. Colour of the frame, obviously it's not the most exciting colour right now, and definitely different to what we've had in the past, but once the race season kicks off we'll have the proper race colours, which are going to be a lot more interesting, a lot better to look at, and something you're all just going to have to wait and see how it's looking. I do like bacon. I like British bacon.